Grace and peace, grace and peace. This is Brother Minister Everett Hakeem Gilliam L. of Agape Speaks Outreach, coming to you today to share with you a message from M to M empowerment, man to empowerment. Agape man to empowerment is a vehicle and a coaching mentorship where we mentor to the mindset of a man. We mentor to the mindset of a man as to really what a man should be and how a man was created in the image and after the likeness of God. Many of you may not know, but in 2020, I had started a ministry, called Manhood Restored, modeled after the late and great Eric Mason. Eric Mason started Manhood Restored because he saw the need that men should continue to grow into the body of Christ and be a type and shadow of Christ here on earth as he was. And so what I want to do is I want to continue to pick back up and share with you today with M to M empowerment as to what it is to be a man. What it is to be a man. What is a real man? I had the privilege in my upcoming years to be called man. My granddaddy named me man. He named me man because I believe that he saw something in me. He saw a potential in me. He saw a need that I needed because I grew up really without a father. The only father that I had in my life was my grandfather. And so he did his best to actually position me into being what a man should be. By first and foremost, titling me, naming me. The word of God says that a good name is better than gold. And so when you actually are called man, when you are able to reconcile and remember that God created man in his image and after his likeness, then you have reconciled your mind back to your divine creation. You have actually caused the identity crisis that you have. You have now caused the misnomer of what the world has said that you are. You have now begun to be formed again. See, the word of God said that God said, let us make man. And so what we're doing at M to M Empowerment is we are remaking man into the image and after the God in which he was born. And so what I want to do, I want to share something with you in regards to the late and great Dr. Miles Monroe, who's no longer with us, but here in spirit and truth. And Dr. Miles Monroe was very, very, very passionate about relationship. He was very passionate about the role of a man. He was very passionate about the role of a woman because he understood what the word of God said in the beginning of Genesis when it says, let us make man in our image. Let us make he and she. And so when we actually make man, what we're doing is we're focusing on our half. We're focusing on our being. We're focusing on our true purpose as men of God. And so men need to know that their given identity has to come with the purposes of what God has created them to be. So the only way that you can walk into your true identity as a man is unless you know your true purpose that God created you to be that man. And so we have to understand that real men can finally come to a place when they read and understand what God has created them to be. They can really come to a fulfillment of the tradition of what men was before the world formed them. See, the thing is, you got to understand that you're not your true self because you've gained accolades, you've gained prestige, you've gained followers, you've gained finance. That doesn't make you who God created you to be. See, the word lets us know that finance don't make the man. It's national standards that make the man. It's principles of God that makes the man. It's the virtue of life that God put in a man that makes a man. Your strength, your muscles, your brain power, that does not make a man. What makes a man is his passion to be a man. His passion to express and fulfill the role of what a man truly is to be. His passion for seeing Men become what God intended them to be. Boys to be raised by men. Boys to become what God intended for them to be. See, a man is not a thug. A man is not a nigger. A man is not a dog. A man is a God. The word of God said, ye are God's children of the Most High. And so I want to explain one thing to you that Dr. Miles Monroe says. He says that there are some images that project or predict manhood, and these images are false. See, low self-esteem for a man becomes prevalent, becomes a power in his life when he subscribes to, you know, the impression of others. When you're feeling like, you know, your identity is measured by the views or by the perception of another, then you fall short of what God has created you to be. Because you all know that deep in your heart, you are who God created you to be, but you're allowing the lie to live. You're allowing the lie to live. And so we have to understand that the true purpose of a man is going to come with a crisis, but it's not a crisis where you don't understand who Christ is, because the word of God tells you that Christ in you is the hope of glory. So your identity should come from the Christ that's in you, the identity that's in you, not the identity that you see in the mirror, not the identity that people have looked up to, not the identity that was formed through family tradition, but you should be measuring yourself according to the word of God. You should be breaking away from the addictions. You should be breaking away from the habits. You should be breaking away from the perceptions that has caused you to see yourself less than what you truly are. So in order to break these bonds, we have to pick up the word of God and understand that we have to restore man back to his original self. We have to restore man back to the original man in whom he was created after his father in the heavens here on earth. We have to understand that the things that we see, the things that we try to measure ourselves up to, these are not the things, these are not the tools that allow us to come into who we are as men. These are not the tools that allow us to be formed or be made up or transitioned into who we are to be. These are the things that has been put in place to distract us from truly being true men of God, true boys coming into manhood. We all know that coming up, there was a movie in Hollywood called Rambo. We've seen movies like James Bond. And these movies projected what masculinity was. In Rambo, masculinity was to be rebellious. Masculinity was to be, you know, aggressive. Masculinity was to be a killer. But we all see that Rambo still had a passion. He still had a heart. He was just doing what he had to do based on the society, the environment that he was put in. And today, the environment that some of our men are put in is toxic. The environment is toxic because it's bombarded with imagery. It's bombarded with peer pressure. It's bombarded with sex. It's bombarded with drugs. It's bombarded with killing. It's bombarded with everything that's in opposition to God. And so it's hard for a boy to understand his true role of walking into maturity. It's like the Apostle Paul said that, you know, when I was a child, I did childish things, but when I became a man, I put away childish things. So today, a lot of boys, a lot of young men, a lot of men don't understand how to put away childish things because they don't have the rubric of the word of God. They don't have the rubric of a Christ-like counselor, and they don't know how to seek godly counsel so that they can be the man that God created them to be. And so they take the role of a Rambo. They take the role of a thug. And they take the role of a James Bond, being manipulative, being, you know, the ladies' man. They take this pimpish role and they try to manipulate themselves into being really a man. And that's what we call a manipulative man. A manipulative man is one that's truly not operating from the virtues of God as a Proverbs man, a virtuous man, a man of valor. He's a man that's actually operating from a manipulating, misdirecting, miseducated mindset. And so he needs a mindset mission to become a minded man, a mind man of God. And so this is why at Agape Speaks Outreach, we want to address the mindset with mentorship. We want to address the mindset with ministry so that when men get ministry, they understand how to be and perform a ministry. See, to be a man is to perform a ministry as to whom God created you to be. And so, it says here, it says, a crisis of roles. Because we understand that today, you know, it's so conflicting as to really what a man is to be. A man today is measured by how much money he makes. You know, women today say he's not a real man if he can't do this. He's not a real man if he's not saying or speaking or look like this. So all these misnomers are the dictatings of what a man is. When a man has not truly been taught really how to be a man in order for him to reflect as a man, to reflect as a father, to reflect as a husband. And what happens is you buy into the lie. You buy into the lie. So what makes our current culture situation unsettling for men is that males have traditionally defined their manhood from their roles they see and function through the performance of family, society, and entertainment. So that's the misnomer. That's the disconnect. That is the unsettling situation for men today, is that they've taken their role, they've taken their perception from everybody but God, from everybody but the scripture. But however, there's been a major shift in the roles of both males and females. The role society has placed on men is changing men from men. And this happens just in the last couple of years, where things have heightened to attack the malehood, to attack really what men should be, because it's no different than what Pharaoh was trying to do in the scriptures. He was trying to attack the men so that he can prevent the Messiah and the message that men have. See, there's a Messiah that lives in you. And in that Messiah comes a message. And that message is the solution to a mess that has been made, that has been created. And so, men's basic concepts of manhood are therefore being disrupted. They feel displaced. They feel unattractive. They feel rejected. They feel isolated. They feel unwanted. They feel unappreciated. And so we have to understand that this could be frustrating and it can be a struggle to adapt to. And so the reason it's frustrating and it's a struggle is because it should be a rubbish that you see that you must grow through in order to become reconciled and renewed back into the original man that God created you to be. So when you're going through a discomfort, when you're going through a miseducation, when you're going through an uncomfortable atmosphere, it should be an indicator that you must now develop self-preservation in order to truly walk in the purpose of what God has created you to walk in, to be the man that God created you to be. And so, the traditional roles that are to be abandoned, the traditional roles that are to be abandoned today are in question because we really don't, as men, don't see the traditional roles that were placed on us from the traditional roles that we really should have been created and walking in. So we have not gotten discernment as to really how we should walk. Why? Because we don't understand the purpose and the power of men. We don't understand that God had designed everything a male should be and the identity that a male should have. God designed that when he said, let us make man. So let us understand this. Let us see. Let us question, is a man still supposed to be the brain winner and the protector? Is a man supposed to still be the person that bring home all the bacon? And today, society says that, you know, a male should be this way. A man should look this way. A man should be this way. This is what a man. We see it all over the television. We see it all over the industries that we are attached to. And so what happens is that we don't get it. We don't get it. And then a man becomes not sure as to really who he is or is supposed to be. Is a man still the leader and the authority in the home? Dr. Miles Monroe says that it isn't clear anymore. Why? Because a man can't be a man in the home. He can't be the head of the home. Because society said he doesn't make that much. Society says that, you know, he's not the breadwinner. You know? And so this is the things that cause a man to have insecurities. These are the things that cause a man to have less confidence in himself. Because he feels that, you know, he's not met the expectations of the world. And he truly had forgotten the expectations of who he is in spite of these things. His DNA, his genetic light causes him to be a man. The blood that's rolling through his veins, the brain that God created and gave him, the body members that God had positioned and put in him, this is what stamps his approval of being a man. When he take this same body, the same temple, and he aligned and atoned with the word of God and to walk in the footprints that was cut by Christ, this is what really stamps his approval of being a man. Because he's spiritually, meaning that he's genetically, because to be spiritually awakened, to be spiritually endowed into what God has created you to be, that means that you have an awakening to be what God has created you to be. So Dr. Miles Monroe says that the woman says, you are not my authority. I'm not a slave. I make my own money and my own decisions. I do what I want to. I call you when I'm ready for you. A man doesn't know how he's supposed to relate to a woman any longer. So he kind of manipulates. He kind of looks at her as a second-class citizen. He kind of takes advantage of her. He kind of brings expectations on her that she may not be able to meet. And so this is what causes a man to not be able to understand how to be who he should be, or it may bring him into a place where he don't understand what his role should be, because he does not understand that tradition has changed. Tradition has changed. But because tradition has changed and the world has picked up and tried to placate really the trueness of what we should be and how relationships should be, then what happens is we become miseducated and unfit. Should a man still show chivalry? Should he open the door for a woman, escort her, pay for her meal on a date, and so on? A man will pull out a chair for a woman and she'll say, "That's all right, thank you very much, but I'll pull out my own chair." Sometimes a man will open a door for a woman and she'll be offended. "Do you think I'm crippled?" She'll demand. If a woman walks into a room and a man stands up out of respect, she might look at him as if he's crazy. A man isn't sure if he should be nice to a woman anymore. So what Dr. Miles Monroe is saying here is that every one of us have come into this conflict as to our role. But in coming into that conflict as to our role is because as a man, you're not in your role. You're not playing your role. When you focus on your role, when you focus on you as a man, when you walk in your own lane and your own path as into whom God created you to be, then everything else will align itself. The word of God says, "Seek ye first the kingdom of God." Seek ye first the kingdom. Get your mind right. Have the mind in you that was also in Christ Jesus. Have the mind to be the man of God the way Christ was the man of God. How he imitated his father, you must imitate God on purpose equally and eternally. Because we have to understand that it is a man who still has to defend himself and his family. It is a man that God calls to keep his wife without spot or blemish. Keep his life without spot or blemish. And so we have to see and understand that many men are thinking today, how and where do I start being a man? How can I be the example of those who are out here looking at me? How can I be an example for my children? I have 9 children, 8 boys and 1 girl. And I truly believe that I am a wonderful and great father. I believe I'm a great role model. And it's not to toot my own horn, but it's because my intentions is to be the best and the greatest godly father and man that I can be to my children. I've never walked out on my children. I consistently be in their life today. They know I love them. And they respect me. And so I believe that I'm putting myself in the alignment of what God wants me to be in order for them to have an ideal of what a man should be. An ideal of what and how a man should treat his children. And so we have to see that if you are a male, right, and you feel that your work and your relationship and your view of the world are being turned upside down, as Dr. Miles Monroe said, you're not alone. You're not alone if you're struggling as to how to walk as this man of God, how to be what God wants me to be, how to look beyond, you know, this fake image, this fake personality that I've created, this Frankenstein. How do I move beyond that? If you are confused as to how to get beyond that, you're not alone. You're not alone. T.D. Jakes, Pastor T.D. Jakes says in his book, So You Call Yourself a Man. And in his book, So You Call Yourself a Man, he said that God is waiting for men to get in position. He said, God is waiting for men to get in position. So the thing you have to do as a man is not try to figure out. Don't try to figure out how to understand or how to get past this confusion as to what you feel or what you want to know what a man is. The thing is that you should just get in position, because God is waiting for you to get in position. Things must be placed before God will act. Things must be in place. The Bible is telling us that in the beginning of creation, God had not caused it to rain on the earth because, why? He wanted everything to be in place before he started creating. And up until that time, God had caused a mist, a void. And so where there's a void as to who you are as a man, where there may be a void as to you not having the right relationship or the correct relationship that you want, or the expected needs that you may need or feel, whatever it may be, you got to understand that that void is because God is about to create something. God is about to speak into your life, but he's waiting for you to get in position. He's waiting for you to get in position in order for his provision for who he created you to be manifested. And so he desires that his will be done when you desire to say, not by my will, but let your will be done. See, when you are sitting in position and you allowing your will to become God's will, that's when God will begin the provision for what he's already created you to be in heaven, here on earth. So this is the blessing. This is the blessing. The blessing is that you need to be insistent. You need to not be resistant. You need to be persistent in its plans in order for you to prosper into who God created you to be. And so, let me read this. It says, men of all ages are grappling with competing views and values of manhood, all right? And so since we are grappling with competing views of manhood, what happens? What happens when we are grappling with competing views of manhood? And we have not put ourselves in position to allow God's provision to remake man in his image and in his likeness. What happens is the historical roles, they change. The historical roles begin to change. And every day, living as a man becomes a struggle. And so, when we allow ourselves as men to get fixated on everything outside of us as a man, being desperate, being needy, being attached, when we allow ourselves to be in a low, carnal, fleshly nature, that's uncontrolled, we set ourselves up for failure. We set ourselves up to desire to take, desire to steal, kill, and destroy. Because why? We're no longer acting as gods, children of the Most High. We're being little devils. So, the struggle for survival and being a man, people live in a more hostile physical environment in which day-to-day living becomes a struggle instead of them walking upright, fearless, and independent as men. Dr. Miles Monroe says, when a man went out to get food for his family, there was no guarantee that he would come back alive. He could have been fatally wounded. He could have been exposed to an animal of aggression. And so therefore, the woman rejoiced to see him come home again. The same basic attitude held true in our parents' and grandparents' time, when most husbands were the sole breadwinners of their families and their wives stayed home. So we know today that that's totally different. Things have changed. And so because things have changed, it does not mean that you as a man should change. What you do is you adapt. What you do is you level up. What you do is you complement, because today's society don't give us the advantage where one can stay home unless you're a millionaire, unless you got everything going. And there is some aspects of that where, you know, one or the other can chill. But let's speak reality for those who haven't. Teamwork makes the dream work. Let us create him and her, he and she. Let them have dominion. So in order for them to have dominion, today's society is calling for them to go work the field, that they can have dominion, that they can be man and woman, the king and queen of their own. They can begin to mount up and become self-preneurs. See, once you align yourself, once you put yourself in position, then you can do it. You can achieve the greatness. You can become all that you can be in the army of God. And so he goes on and says that sometimes the only job a man could get was working long hours in the field or underground in a coal mine. When a man came home limping, his wife knew he had risked his health and even his life to keep bread on the table. The family Miles Monroe said, the family that I grew up in was this typical family and not so distant past. He says his father rose in the morning before the children got up and came home after they had gone to bed. So today, you know, society pulls us into that traditional way, but at the same time, it's pulling us away from God. It's making you work long and countless hours, but it's causing you to be less functional with being a role model, being the man, the husband, being a father, because everything becomes a priority outside of the true role and the dynamics of a man and his family. So I'm gonna stop here, because I wanted to just basically introduce really what is a man. And I wanted to introduce that what is a real man is, because we're going to actually go into, you know, empowering men to take their contemporary roles of really whom God created them to be. We want to here at Agape M2M Empowerment to allow men to come into a place where they can heal, where they can come into a place and they can spiritually develop. They can be counseled to walk in Christ-like manner. They can become whom God created them to be. And they can really do it on a realistic manner. Because we all have the experience that we can offer the prevention of a cure. Prevention is better than cure. So if I can prevent you from going and doing the things I did as an immature man, then I can minimize the cure for you in the future. So with that being said, thank you again. And don't forget to subscribe. Hit that like button. And as we, again, at M2M Empowerment, are here to restore man back to his original self, to be the man that God created him to be, that he can think and grow godly rich into his nature of Christ-like manner. So with that being said, y'all be blessed. Look forward to seeing you again. Don't forget to share this video, that we can restore man back to his original self. If you know anyone, any man that's struggling, he don't have to struggle alone. Let us remake man.